another Amazing World of Gumball reaction on season 1, episode 13.
What is this called?
The mystery. Okay, there's obviously a fucking mystery involved. What else do you want me to say? I don't know. Again, I've said this so many times in so many episodes, but with this show, I never know what to predict, because, like, the most random shit happened in this show. Because, yeah, what was last episode? It was the ghost. That kid at the school, like, the ghost girl. I forgot her name. Like, she fucking possessed Gumball and all that shit. Like, I don't know. I'm guessing there's some sort of mystery that Gumball and Darwin have to solve. Might as well get into it. Let's go.
I think cheese is better than cake. Because you can have cheesecake, but you can't have cake cheese.
Actually, that is a very good fucking argument, though. Is cheese better than cake? Actually, probably. You could probably have cheese on better more things.
What's going on here? What are you poking? It looks like a wet diaper.
Who is that? Oh, it's the fucking principal. Oh, my God.
Who would shave you, paint you, wrap you in toilet paper, and shut you in water and blogger? Who did this?
Oh, is this gonna be the mystery on who did it?
And if the culprit hasn't owned up by the time I get back, you're all in detention.
Oh, no, again, that's fucking ridiculous. Like, what?
So, what do you guys...
They kind of zoomed in a bit, folk, of that fucking... robot kid back in the background.
Guys, I didn't do it, but I'm gonna find out who did.
Okay, good.
I think I know just how.
How?
Whoever did it, raise your hand.
Yeah, that was just... great one.
Okay. Whoever didn't do it, raise your hand. What? Aha! So you did it.
Okay, that kid doesn't have arms.
Clues. Like those paint splatters all over your pom-poms!
Yeah, what the fuck? Why is...
No, wait! I can explain!
Okay.
There's only one explanation.
Sure.
It's a crime of passion.
What do you mean?
You knew Principal Brown put me in detention last night, and overwhelmed by your feelings for me,
oh, for fucking...
confronted him in his office.
What?
Please, let him go!
Okay, this is fucking... this is actually really funny.
If Penny didn't do it, who did?
It must have been you!
I said it was him!
Why me?
Well, yeah, why the fuck would he do it?
You were one
like, he seems like one of the most chill people in the show.
I realized your youth was behind you.
Oh.
Then all your hair fell out.
What?
Bummer.
When you saw Principal Brown's lustrous hairy coat, you were over.
Okay,
jealous.
They've got different colored hair. How the fuck is that gonna work? Unless he dyed it.
Dyed at the right
color. Oh, okay, never mind.
And use it to cover your balding shame. The only person who knew the combination to the locker Principal Brown was found in. You!
Who? Oh.
Oh.
That's all the proof I need. You're coming with...
What? Okay. Just because it's his locker.
A bit of crucial evidence.
And what's that?
I'll just... go and get it.
Okay, I'm very curious to see what this crucial evidence is.
A little better.
Well, not anymore. Oh my God!
This is extraordinarily painful. It couldn't possibly get any worse.
Oh my God, okay, well he should be dead.
Principal Brown was attacked and everyone thinks it was me.
But it wasn't you.
Exactly! Wait, how come you believe me?
Yeah, what?
I saw everything.
I thought they sort of focused on in that fucking kid when he was in the background.
And Darwin's toilet paper smashed into Penny's artwork, covering his face in paint, then fell back into Rocky's chemicals, burning
oh my God.
Hair, then down more stairs, wrapping himself in even more toilet paper, and finally into Gumball's locker.
How did I put that together that it makes so much sense? Especially with the amount of fucking toilet paper Darwin had wrapped on his leg.
So, the true culprit is the person who threw open Principal Brown's door.
Exactly. Zoom in 100%. Zoom in another 100%. Enhanced video.
Fuck's sake. It didn't work the first time. What did you expect?
It was you all along. We're going to tell Principal
Brown.
Oh, it
was the fucking teacher.
Tell him what?
Well, we just saw in Bobbert's memory.
Erase
memory.
Oh my God. This teacher's fucking just a little bit evil.
Has anyone seen Miss Simeon?
And she's... Oh my God. How the fuck are these, like, people get severely fucking, like, several bones shattered. Okay, that was fucking entertaining. I really enjoyed that. I feel stupid for not, like, putting it together that the principal basically, like, fell down the stairs and did it himself. Because it makes so much sense. Because, you know, Darwin had the fucking toilet paper attached to his foot. And he went around, like, pretty much the entirety of the school with toilet paper on him. And the fucking entire school was covered in it. Plus, like, the paint thing with Penny. I mean, I guess the locker thing with Gumball was kind of, like, that was probably the hardest thing to sort of figure out. That he just had the locker open and the principal fell into it. So wait, does that mean the principal was stuck in the locker all night? Also, I find it funny the fact that he fucking got better. I was like, oh, I'm feeling well. They fell out of a window. Also, I find it so funny when why do I keep saying Darwin instead of Gumball? I find it funny with Gumball, his so-called, like, story of how it was Penny and why her motivations behind it, because she was in love with him, which I thought that was fucking funny. But anyway, that's it. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed. See you next week. Bye bye.